Hi, this is Dr. A. We're going to look at the diagnostic and the therapeutic procedures for the ears. So let's start with some audiology tests. So an audiogram is a graphic record of audiometry results. An audiometer is an instrument used to measure hearing. Audiometry is a test of hearing ability that determines the lowest and highest intensities and the frequencies a person can distinguish. A decibel is a measure of the loudness of a sound, and a hertz measures the pitch of a sound. The Rinn and Weber tuning fork test are tests that assess nerve and bone conduction of sound. It involves holding a tuning fork against or near the bones on the side of a patient's head. For example, here is an audiometry exam being administered to a young child, and she is wearing earphones to which the sounds are given. So some otology tests. So we have an otoscope as an instrument used to view inside the ear canal. Otoscopy is a process of examining the ear canal, the outer ear, and the eardrum using an otoscope. Tympanogram is a graphic record of the results of tympanometry, and tympanometer is an instrument used to measure the movement of the tympanic membrane, and tympanometry is a measurement of the movement of the tympanic membrane to assess pressure inside the middle ear. Here's an otoscope used to visually examine the external auditory ear canal and the tympanic membrane. For the balance test, there's a falling test. It's done to assess equilibrium, and the patient is observed standing on one foot, then with one foot in front of the other, and then walking forward, first with the eyes open and then with the eyes closed. And then wherever they lose balance, it can indicate different balance problems. Some audiology procedures. So American Sign Language is a nonverbal method of communicating in which the hands and fingers are used to indicate words and concepts. Then a hearing aid is an apparatus or a mechanical device that is used by persons with impaired hearing to amplify sound. Now some surgical procedures. A cochlear implant is a mechanical device surgically placed behind the outer ear. It converts sounds into magnetic impulses to stimulate the auditory nerve. It is used to treat profound sensorineural hearing loss. Labyrinthectomy is the surgical removal of the labyrinth, and labyrinthotomy is cutting into the labyrinth. Meningectomy is the surgical removal of the tympanic membrane, and meningoplasty is a surgical repair of the tympanic membrane. Here is a cochlear implant on a child. And meningotomy is a surgical puncture of the eardrum to drain the fluid and pus from the middle ear. A pressure equalizing tube is in place in the tympanic membrane. Otoplasty is the surgical repair of the external ear. A pressure equalizing tube is a small tube that is surgically placed in the eardrum to assist in fluid drainage and to equalize the pressure in the middle ear. Salpingotomy is cutting into the auditory tube, and stapedectomy is the removal of the stapes to treat otosclerosis. Tympanectomy is a surgical removal of the tympanic membrane, and tympanoplasty is a surgical repair of the tympanic membrane. Tympanotomy is cutting into the tympanic membrane. That's tympanotomy. And then lastly, we have pharmacology. We have an antibiotic otic solution or ear drops to treat otitis externa, so for the external ear, like neomycin and otocort. An anti-emetic, it treats nausea that is associated with vertigo, like antivert or compazine. And a wax emulsifier, it softens earwax to prevent buildup in the external ear canal. And for example, Debrox drops are an example of that. And so, yeah, that wraps up our pharmacology and diagnostic and therapeutic procedures for the ear.